Good morning, all of you. Welcome to communications class. Today we will see some of the basic communications operations. So before going to discuss in the overview some topics in communications, first you should know that what is the definition of communications. So the definition of communications is like this. So transmitting or conveying information from the one point to another point, or transmitted receiver is what is communication. So communicating may be a wired communication or wireless communication. That means if you are using it between the transmitter and receiver, a media is called as a wire, it is called as wired communication. If a media is a wireless, it is called as wireless communication. Like this. See, the basic blocks of the communication is like this. Transmitter, receiver. Like this. Transmitter, receiver. So if you have wired communication between this one, it is called as wired communication. Any type of wireless. So this in a wireless, there is no proper physical wireless distinction between the transmitter is called as wireless communications. So this we know generally. The information may be transferred to a shorter distance as well as the longer distance also. Depends on applications. You can choose any one of the communications, wired communications or wireless communications. So before we are discussing about all the communications, first thing we should know that what are different modes of communications. Different modes of communications. So what is the different types of communications to modes of communication? Nothing but types of communications, you know, give you, it will be a wired communication, wireless communication, analog communication, digital communications. So here more than that, how we are communicating. That means between the two points, is somebody transmitting or somebody receiving? So if it's acting as a transmitter or receiver, or acting as a both. Likewise, the receivers are learned also, whether transmitting or receiving or both. So that is called as the modes of communications. What type of mode it is used for communication purpose? Here, first thing is that the mode of communication is called as synchronous communication. What is synchronous communication? So when you transfer data from the one point to other point, need not be always a transmitter or a receiver. Anything may be. So if it is acting a transmitter and the other one is acting a receiver, that means always it always transfer the data, it always receive data. Vice versa is not possible. That means only one way communication is called as syntax communication or complex mode of communication. Okay? Now it is transmitting in a sequence, that's all it is. There is no other possible of the transmitting or conveying information to the points. Okay? Next. Second one is called as half duplex. Half duplex. So what is this mean by half duplex is? So the two ends are there, it will be a transmitter receiver. So when it is transmitting, this has to listen or has to receive. And when it transmitting, this has to receive. That means communication is possible both ways, but not simultaneously. Yes, when it transmitting like this, transmitting from this end to this end, that is transmitting. That time it is in the receiving mode only. Okay. So unlike this one, it can transmit and it can receive, but it's not a data. So this can possible as acting as transmission as a reception, but not data. Similarly, this can acting as receiver as well as transmission, but not data. Okay, that is called as half duplex mode of communication. Second one is called as full duplex mode of communication. What is full duplex mode? So if the two ends are there, between the two ends, so you can transmit, receive at any point of time. Can transmit as a receiver simultaneously also. Simultaneously, transmission, reception is possible between the points. This is called as full duplex mode of communications. So nowadays, all applications, or nothing but major 90% of applications, is used in this full duplex mode of communication only. So there are those very less amount of areas are there where we use this half duplex mode of communications. This like simplest example is called as a walkie-talkie. In walkie-talkie, when somebody is talking now, the receiver must listen. Okay, after finishing this one, we can transmit your voice. That is what this is. The best example for the half duplex modem communications. So similarly, we have different types of communications based upon the signal. If the communication is done through the analog signal, it is called as analog communication. If communication happening through the digital signal, it is called as the digital communications. So we have everything is there in the analog and digital communications. Analog and digital communications. So for the basic operations for this communication is not that transmit and receive. I told you, no? So transmitting, I am acting as transmitter, receiver. Maybe, you know, in a short way of clock cycle, I represent it like this: transmitter, channel, receiver. So if you allow the receiver also, we have a lot of operations are there. Like basic information to the data or signal to the modulation to the encoding to the communication. So all these operations will be performed in the transmitter side. Similarly, a receiver is also decoding, demodulation and amplifying. So that's a lot of operations involved. So among all, the basics of the communication is the demodulation operation. Modulation operation is the basic operation in the communications. So what is modulation? Changing the characteristics of a carrier signal. In communications, for short distance of communications, we don't require any carrier. For example, I'm talking about something now. So my voice has to reach the longer distance. That time it need a carrier. But shorter for distance now, like this much of area, so don't need any carrier. Okay? Sound will directly transmit through the wave to reach the receiver. But for the longer distance, for example 100 meters, 200 meters, like that time, you need to have a carrier. Here, basically, a communication is having a message signal as well as the carrier signal. Message signal as well as carrier signal. So, always this signal frequency is, for example, this FM is message signal frequency and carrier signal frequency is at this FC. So, rest of the output may be increased, decreased, doesn't matter. But whereas from the frequency, the carrier frequency always must be greater than the 5 star x SS signal. Then only it is possible to transmit the signal properly. Okay? That is for the difference between the message signal as well as the carrier signal. So now what I told you, changing the characteristics of carrier signal with respect to message signal is called the modulation. So what is the change characteristics? Any signal is having three types of the characteristics. One is amplitude, second one is phase, and third one is frequency. So these are the major characteristics that have any signal, any continuous signal. So if it's that, so it is called as that name of modulation, like amplitude modulation, phase modulation, frequency modulation, also name. So we'll see the classification of the modulations. So the classification of modulations based upon what type of wave it is used. Like you see now, the first one is called as continuous wave modulation. Means both input as well as output in the continuous wave only. So here we will be having two types. One is amplitude modulation, second one is angle modulation. Amplitude modulation, second one is angle modulation. So in amplitude modulation, actually we have different types of categories are there. Initial amplitude modulation will be having DSB, SC, double segment surface carrier, third one is called as SSB, SC, single segment surface carrier, and last one is called as VSB, SC. VSB is here, segment. So, initially, amplitude modulation is having some products. Aside from VSB, DSB, SC. In terms of the power calculations, in terms of the bandwidth, in terms of the errors. Okay? That's why it is VSB, SC. Again, compare these different operations, the same thing is the bandwidth management problem as per the power requirement for the transmission. Okay? So, application is based. So, we have designed that in amplitude modulation only VSB, vestigial sideband, based upon signals. So, we have different types of modulations called as vestigial sideband. Similarly, in angle modulation, we will be having its phase modulation as well as the frequency modulation. phase modulation as well as frequency modulation is categorized in the angle modulation. Next one is your pulse modulation. In pulse modulation, we will have a pulse amplitude modulation, pulse frequency modulation, and pulse position modulation. These are the three things are the modulations where we will be using the pulse based modulations. Okay. So it's having its own advantages as well as its own disadvantages. Pulse is nothing but is again continuous signal only, but pulse modulations. Next we will have a PCM, DPCM, and DM. We call again ADM. So this is called pulse code modulation, differential pulse code modulation, delta modulation, as well as the app delta modulation. Where so based upon the quantization is used here. So it's some kind of quantization point here. So based upon different types of quantization is used. Yeah, different types of modulations are there. So we have three types of modulations are there. One is uniform quantization. Second is non-uniform quantization. Third one is differential quantization. So based upon this one, we can tell these things. So everything that is different is whatever disadvantage is there, that is going to fall from the next level of the modulation here. So apart from this one, we have one more called as digital type of modulations, where the entire data has been converted into digital. Here the continuous wave input signal analog signal only, output signal analog signal only, in both continuous wave modulations. So whereas here the input also continuous signal only, output also pulse based output will get. Pulse based output will get output here. Here in this modulation, the input is continuous signal only, outputs are in terms of the ones and zeros. Outputs are in terms of the ones and zeros. Next comes to this system modulation, so here we will be having a input is a digital signal, output again a continuous type of signal for the applications. So here we will be having a operations for us ASK, PSK, FSK. ASK, PSK, FSK is used. So here again we can get this in the two things. One is 2 power n based modulation result. If n is equal to 1, if n is equal to 1, these are called as BASK, BPSK, and BFSK quarters. Similarly, n is going to be increased. For example, n is equal to 4, we call as the QASK. Nothing but 4A, 4ASK, we call as the QASK. Like QPSK and QBPS, BFSK. If it is by n is equal to 8, n is equal to 1 is this one, n is equal to this one, n is equal to 1 is 8. Like this 8ASK, 8PSK, 8FSK, like this. So it can tell us like this one. The basic thing is that how this converting. So I just give you an introduction that how this is going to be giving you this shifting operations here. So I will take an example rather respect to outcome how this digital data is being converted to again continuous. So why is it shifting gains here? Means digital data cannot be transmitted by its own. It has to convert into continuous signal. In communications, it may be analog communication or digital communication, data must be in the format of signal format only, continuous signal format only. Though you name it as a digital communications, it must be a continuous signal format only. Because of that, when you say that digital communication is best communications, so if it's best means, though it's best digitally, but the data is there, it must be converted into signal, then it can be transmittable to the channel. Channel will be a wired channel or wireless channel. So we'll take an example of this one, 101101. What happens in ASK? In ASK, you'll be having ASK modulations, either BASK. You'll be having two types of the amps are the binder. One is amplitude of its own, like the signal is there, amplitude is its own, and amplitude is 0 volts. Like this will be there. And dependent one is something with the signal, 0 is the 0 signal like this. So you get like this. Again, this one is 1, 0, this one is 1. Like that again. So this is going to be calculated, but not this one. Similarly, in the BPSK, in BPSK, when successive bits are changing like this, then you will be shifting to the warrant address. Success bits are not changing. If it is 0011, you are just giving the 0 to phase shift. So two types of phase shift. Two means binary. Binary phase shifting operation and project. So one, first initially I can say this is one like this. If my carry signal is like this, so initially 1 is 1. So 1 to 0, state change. So can be changed by the frequency by 1 degrees. This is the frequency by 1 degrees. Similarly, 0 to 1, so I have to change this frequency like this. 1 degrees something. You can change it to 0 to 1. Again, 1 to 1, there is no change. Again, 1 to 0, change of the states. I have to change the frequency. Again, 0 to 1 is there. I have to change the frequency. Like this, change of the frequency is there. Wherever the change of the states, 1 to 0 or 0 to 1, based upon the states. Whereas in BFSK, these are two carriers actually. So one is carrying with the normal signal, another is carrying with the high frequency. Wherever one is there, I am going with the same carrier frequency. Wherever 0 is there, I am taking the high frequency signal. So you see now 1, I am taking the same signal. Wherever 0 now, I am taking the high frequency signal like this. Wherever 1 is there, I am taking the same signal. 1 is there, same signal. Wherever 0 is there, I am taking the high frequency signal. So this is called BFSK. Shifting bits frequency with 2 weeks. So if you apply carefully, my input signal to the shifting operation is a digital signal, but output is continuous format. This can be not transmittable in the communication, but not this data as it is. Likewise, you can characterize the shifting operation in the communications. So this is used in the digital communications. So lot of advantages are there, lot of properties are there. Like one of the most important properties called as quantization error, called as quantization error and probability of error. Probability of error. So these are the most important concepts are there, as well as bit rate, okay, bandwidth. Lot of concepts are there. We will discuss these things. No, differentiate. Those points to be discussed with respect to all these operations. So this is a little class to the communications, starting from the what is communications and now coming from the what are the utmost used digital communications nowadays. So nowadays in the all type of digital communications using the BPSK as well as the BPSK type of the operations with the digital communications like internet class. That's all about today's session. I will continue.